What's up guys, Sitch Kogolan here, welcome to this new episode. In today's video, I'm going to be playing with the fastest Mega Knight Cycle deck in Clash Royale. As you guys can see, we of course have the Mega Knight, we have all the 1 Elixir cards possible in Clash Royale. I put the Zap as a 2 Elixir card and it's also going to be our evolution. And then I put the cheapest champion to be able to have a 3 card cycle and cycle even faster towards the Mega Knight. So we're going to be playing it on Grand Challenge. I feel like if I play this deck on top ladder, I probably will just get destroyed. And in Grand Challenge, I guess we'll still have a chance. But it's not gonna be easy because this deck doesn't look insanely strong or anything like that. Okay, let's start off with skeletons here. Looks like this guy's gonna be running something with Firecracker. Could maybe be a Hawk Rider deck, or I guess maybe in the first. Oh, looks like he goes Elixir Collector. Okay, I'm gonna try to punish it with a Mega Knight here. I'm also gonna go with Little Prince, and I'm gonna try to activate the King Tower with a Fire Spirit towards the Firecracker. Looks like with the Dagger Dashes, we were unfortunately not able to activate, but still a very good situation. I'm gonna go with another Zap here to kill those minions. And then the Mega Knight is going to jump straight to the tower and get quite a lot of damage already on the left side tower, especially with the Little Prince here shooting faster. Not sure if I should have went with ability. Maybe with the ability we would have ended up taking the tower, but I think it's still pretty good situation. Not sure what he's running though. He has barbs, he has minions, Firecracker. Could maybe be some... Ooh, looks like he does go with Firecracker right as I go with Ice Spirit plus Skeletons. I guess it's fine though. I think the Ice Spirit, I think the Ice Spirit should be able to connect. And then maybe, can we still activate against the Firecracker with Dagger Dashes? I think if we go like this, we should be able to activate. Or was it? Okay, nice. We will be able to activate. So that's a nice activation. Definitely going to help us out quite a bit. And I'm not sure what he's running. What is his win condition? Looks like it's Giant, Barbarians, Firecracker. Does he? I have no idea what he's running, to be honest. Okay, let's prepare the Evil Zap here on defense. I think the Evil Zap is going to help us quite a bit because it's going to kill the minions. It's gonna help kill the giant, and then afterwards we need to be careful. Okay, let's go with skeletons, and I'm gonna go Mega Knight up high to make sure that we we don't take any more damage from the evil firecracker. And then we actually have a pretty nice counter push here with Mega Knight. Let's go with the spirits here, and then I think we just need to let's just keep it like this. I think it's fine. We forced out the evil barbs. Now afterwards we don't need to worry about the evil barbs anymore. Okay, let's go E-Spirit to tank his fire spirit, and it's also gonna jump on top of the barbarians. And then not really sure. He has such a strange deck. Like, he has just... Is it just gonna be like a giant spam deck? He also, for some reason, has Goblin Barrel in there. I guess that's what you get when you play a Grand Challenge from the first couple of wins. You always face, kind of off-meta decks. Okay, we need to be careful here, though. We definitely need to watch out with this giant push. I think I'm gonna go E-Spirit like this. I'm gonna go Mega Knight up high. And then afterwards, I'm gonna go Zap plus even an Ice Spirit to try and kill the minions. Okay, he does go with Fireball. He's getting a lot of damage with the giant pushes, to be honest. We need to be careful, guys. Let's support the Mega Knight here quite a bit. Let's then also go with our Little Prince. Let's go with Evil Zap on top of this Firecracker. And then thanks to that, we are getting a lot of damage. Okay, let's pop our ability. And then I think I'm going to go with Evil Skeletons just in case he goes with his Barbarians. Or let's see what he's going to do. Let's go with E-Spirit as well. He does go with Fireball, but he misses one of the Skeletons. The Skeleton is going to get to the tower. It's going to be so much damage. And that should also be... good game. Only 10 seconds left. I'm even leaking Elixir. Let's go with Zap here to kill the Evil Firecracker. We can go with Little Prince. Prepare the ability for the Golem Barrel, which is coming any second. No, looks like he's not gonna try. He knows it's over. Time runs out. Very nice Evil Skeletons there. Evil Skeletons are still so broken. In some situations, they can change the outcome of a match, either defensively or also offensively. If they, for example, what just happened? Like, get to the tower. They just go completely crazy and they have no mercy. Okay, looks like we're up against... how do you say that? The new troop? The dagger? I forgot the name, but you guys know what I'm trying to say. The new tower troop, looks like he's running it, so we need to be careful with that, especially when cycling the spirits. But I guess against Mega Knight, it shouldn't be amazing. I mean, it's gonna deal a decent amount of damage to the Mega Knight, but it shouldn't be getting like really good counter against it. So let's see what happens. Let's go with Mega Knight here in the back. Let's go with skeletons. I would like to try and cycle towards the Little Prince. There you go. Let's go with Little Prince now. Then the Little Prince should be able to deal quite a bit of damage towards the Lava Hound. Well, the Mega Knight is going to jump straight to the tower. Okay, let's go here with ability. Let's then afterwards go with the Ice Spirit. No, I wanted the Ice Spirit to jump on top of the Mega Minion. Okay, I guess it's fine. We should be able to defend this. Let's see. Let's go with E-Spirit here. Let's then afterwards go with Zap. I'm going to go with some skeletons here as well. We need to be careful because, the Dagger Dash is whenever it shoots slow. It's just way too bad in my opinion. Okay, let's go E-Spirit here as well. Little Prince is going to help out quite a bit. I think we're not going to lose tower, but we're still going to take so much damage, especially with the Zap. Yeah, I think with the Zap, it is going to be tower actually, because, of course, whenever you Zap the Little Prince, you reset it, and then the hit speed just goes from zero again. Okay, so not the best situation. I think we should maybe still be able to take the tower here with the ability, Heal Spirit, and then we can go with Skeletons for the guards, or maybe... Oh, looks like he has Valkyrie, no way. Okay, I was expecting some Barbarians. Instead, he has Valkyrie. Valkyrie is, of course, going to be amazing against the Evil Skeletons, so we don't even take the tower, and we actually gave him even more value on top of the Valkyrie. He would have went Valkyrie anyways, just with the ability. Okay, let's go Mega Knight at the bridge here. I don't know if it's a good play, but I think we just need to take the tower. He does go with a Lava Hound. My question is, can we still defend afterwards? Okay, let's go Ice Spirit here, so the Mega Knight jumps on top of the tower. That's going to be tower down for sure. The question is, how are we going to defend, guys? How are we going to defend this Lava push? Okay, let's go Little Prince right away. I think he should... Wait, does he have a big spell or he cannot kill? Okay, let's go Zap here. Nice. This Zap is going to get a lot of value. Perfect. Okay, let's go like this. Let's go with E-Spirit afterwards. Then I'm going to go with another Zap on defense. Nice. Okay, I think that's a perfect defense, right? Perfect. Okay, very good defense there. That was amazing. We need to be careful though, because he's going to soon have another Lava Hound ready. I think I'm going to go Mega Knight up high. Nice. That's going to tank quite a bit. Let's then afterwards go with Heal Spirit. Unfortunately, he does cycle arrows right in time. So yeah, the Little Prince is going to go down. But that Mega Knight still got quite a bit of value. And then we actually cycle back to another Mega Knight. Should we go with it? I think I'm going to go with it in the middle. Nice. Perfect timing. Okay, right as he goes with Lava Hound, he does also go with Valkyrie. Let's go with Evil Skeletons. Evil Skeletons will end up dying, but the Valkyrie still... Yeah, ends up dying quite fast as well. And the Mega Knights actually jump on top of the tower. Okay. Wait, is this still winnable? We need to cycle our Evil Zap, guys. I need to cycle the Evil Zap as soon as possible. Okay, let's go Skeletons here. Let's then afterwards go with Evil Zap on defense. I'm going to go with Heal Spirit as well. And then I'm going to go with E-Spirit. Okay, Skeletons to distract. Nice. Okay, how are we defending against Lava Hound? That just shows how strong the Little Prince still is. Okay, perfect. I'm going to go with Ability. Please tell me it jumps. Nice, perfect. And let's then go with the E-Spirit here as well. Okay, the Mega Knight is going to jump on top of the tower. That's going to get a decent amount of chip damage. We need to be careful now because he is going to go... Yeah, I was about to say he is soon going to go with his Lava Push. Okay, let's go Mega Knight here to tank. Let's then go with the Little Prince. We need to try and cycle as soon as possible towards our Zap. Let's go Zap on defense now. Let's then go with the E-Spirit as well. And we need to pray that this balloon is not going to take the tower. No, it's going to take the tower. So that's unfortunate. A very nice game still. I feel like we did a good job at defending. I don't know how we defended some Lava Hound pushes. That was so hard to defend. We just have the Little Prince. And then we just have so many spirits. Plus the Evil Zap. Which I guess is decent in some situation. But at the same time, just wasn't enough. Unlucky that he had Valkyrie. I feel like if he didn't have Valkyrie, but he would have had, for example, Barbarians, I feel like we definitely would have been able to get the W in some situations. Valkyrie just cleaned up everything, especially the Evil Skeletons were kind of useless because of the Valkyrie. Okay, let's go E-Spirit here to distract the mini P.E.K.K.A. I think I'm going to go Mega Knight in the back already, and then let's see what this guy's going to be running. Luckily for us, he has Princess Tower, which I think is actually good, because then, of course, the spirits are more annoying for him. If I go E-Spirit against the Dagger Dashes, if I go E-Spirit against Cannoneer, it doesn't get anything. But if I go any spirit against the Princess Tower, it does actually kill it. Okay, let's wait a little bit. I think I'm going to go Zap to distract the Little Prince. Perfect. And let's then afterwards go with Destruction here on top of the Recruits as well. Nice. Very good push. I'm actually going to go Last Second Ability. I think it should be annoying for him. And then here we can cycle back to another Heal Spirit plus another Zap as well. Okay. Unfortunately, the Zap is not able to kill the Archers, but still a lot of damage dealt to the right side tower. And then we also already cycled the Evil Skeletons. As you guys can see, next card is already Evil Skeletons. So this deck just cycles insanely fast. Okay, let's go with Fire Spirit towards the right side. Not sure what deck he's going to be running. I think it should be maybe a Goblin Giant deck after seeing the cards that he showed. I'm guessing it could be. Okay, let's go Mega Knight here. I think he's going to go Mini P.E.K.K.A. straight on top. So let's go with Evil Skeletons to try to predict the Mini P.E.K.K.A. There you go. Very nice prediction, Skeletons on top of the Mini P.E.K.K.A. Even though he rages, the Mega Knight is still full HP. And it should be tower down on the right side, especially after spending 6 Elixir on the Elixir Collector, 4 Elixir on the Mini P.E.K.K.A., 2 Elixir on the Rage. He just, he doesn't have any Elixir left to be able to defend the Mega Knight. So very nice prediction there with the Skeletons for the Mini P.E.K.K.A. Not sure if I should Zap. I guess I should not Zap, to be honest. I think I'm going to keep the Zap on defense. If he, for example, drops anything, we can maybe go with Evil Zap on defense. Or we could even cycle back to another Mega Knight. This deck, of course, cycles insanely fast. Okay, I think I'm actually going to go Mega Knight right side. I think this Mega Knight should be annoying for him. And then afterwards, we just need to try and cycle back to a nice maybe Mega Knight. Or maybe try to cycle the Evil Skeletons, even though we just used them. So I'm not sure if I can cycle to the Evil Skellies, to be honest. Yeah, let's go with Mega Knight here. Let's then afterwards, I think, go with Skeletons to help kill everything. And then I think that should be fine. Perfect. Nice that we keep the Evil Zap, because this way the Evil Zap is gonna get a lot of value. And that's gonna be a very nice and easy defense here. Okay, I guess he's gonna ability soon. Whenever he's gonna ability, we can go with Skeletons. Or in this case, we can go with Skeletons left side. We even cycle another Mega Knight. Let's go with Mega Knight in the middle here. He does go with the arrows, but that's still gonna be an easy defense thanks to the Dagger Dashes. Let's go with Zap here as well. Unfortunately, it's not gonna kill the Archers, but still so much damage delve to the left side tower. And now we just need to survive 15 seconds more, guys. I think this should be, yeah, pretty much good game. I don't think he's gonna have enough time. And even if he tries to attack, we have a pretty solid defense. Yeah, with this deck, doesn't maybe seem like it, but this deck actually has a pretty solid defense with the Mega Knight, with the Quick Cycle, and the Little Prince helps out quite a bit as well. So very nice W. So far we're 2-1. I think I'm gonna play one more match in this Grand Challenge. Let's see if we can get at least 3 victories with this insanely fast Mega Knight Cycle deck. So far, as I said, we went 2-1. Unfortunately, did end up losing against the Lavan deck. Then we did end up winning against this giant player, and then another kind of giant player, in this case a goblin giant. So let's hop into the next match. See you guys whenever we find the fourth match. Okay, perfect. Right as I say so, we already find it. So that's gonna be nice and quick. Let's go with good luck, and let's start off with skeletons here. Okay, so not sure what he's gonna be running. I mean, Dagger Dashes is basically played in any type of deck, so it doesn't really mean whenever you see the Dagger Dashes that it's gonna be a specific deck. The only bad thing for us is that it's really good against our spirits. Like, for example, last game, the Princess Tower really bad against the spirit, because any spirit, like Fire Spirit, Electro Spirit, any spirit reaches the tower. But against the Dagger Dashes, even if you play like 2 or 3 spirits together, I think none of them get to the tower, because it's so good against spammy cards. So this is gonna be kind of rough. Wait, please don't tell me it's gonna be another Lava on deck. Please tell me it's not gonna be another Lava on deck. That would actually be really sad. Okay, let's go Zap here. Little Prince is gonna take care of everything. We unfortunately are not gonna get any damage out of this, but it still should be decent situation. I'm actually gonna pop ability. I think it's a good ability. Not sure what he has in cycle right now to defend this, but the Dagger Dashes doesn't have that much ammo. And then here we can go with a Heal Spirit as well. Okay, so I think, is this gonna be Lava Hound? I'm not sure actually. He has Bomber, Goblins, Knight. I think it might be Lava Hound, but at the same time, I'm not completely sure. Let me know in the comment section down below what you guys think is gonna be his win condition. I'm not sure, to be honest. Okay, looks like it is indeed gonna be Lava Hound. Interesting. Okay, this is gonna be rough, guys. We already saw in the second match that Lava Hound is not easy at all. But I think we still might be able to win this, to be honest. Let's see what happens. Let's go with Evil Skeletons. Let's go with E-Spirit to be able to distract the Electro Dragon. Very nice. And let's then... I wanted to zap, but I think I'm just gonna let this be, to be honest. And then keep the Elixir for defense. Okay, perfect. Let's go with Fire Spirit. And let's then afterwards go with a Heal Spirit as well. Nice. Okay, we take the tower already. That was amazing. I wasn't expecting to take tower that early, but the Mega Knight push with the Evil Skeletons actually got so much value and even got so much damage to the point where they took the tower already. So amazing. Okay, let's go with another Mega Knight in the back here. I think it's very important to keep up the pressure, especially against this type of deck. You don't really want to let him build like an insanely good Lava Loom push. I rather try to focus on offense here. I'm actually gonna ignore the Lava Hound. Call me crazy, but I think I'm gonna fully ignore the Lava Hound here and try to make like a huge push with 2 Mega Knights. Okay, let's go with another Mega Knight. Let's go with Heal Spirit. Let's then afterwards go with Skeletons. Let's go with Ice Spirit here as well. And I'm gonna go with another Zap. Okay, perfect. We even cycled a third Mega Knight. Do you think we can get 3 Mega Knights at the same time on the field? That will be crazy. Look at the Evil Skeletons as well. Okay, we're not gonna get 3 Mega Knights because one of them already dies. But we are gonna go with another Mega Knight, and that's gonna be another W with this insanely fast Mega Knight cycle deck. So let me know in the comment section down below if you guys would like to see more videos like this, where I play with an insanely quick cycle deck from, I don't know, a specific win condition, maybe an evolution, could be anything. Let me know in the comment section down below what you guys thought about today's video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. Do want to thank you guys so much for all the support in the recent videos. I've seen a lot of support on the last couple of videos, and it does makes me really happy. So thank you guys so much. Keep supporting. Hopefully you guys enjoyed today's video as well. If you did, please make sure to smack the like button. If not subscribed to the channel, feel free to subscribe, and I hope to see you guys in one of my next videos. Take care, guys.